G'day guys, it's Dominic from Cranbourne Music here today, and we're just going to be going through a basic home studio setup using a MacBook Pro, some monitors, an audio interface and a condenser mic. Why do we need an audio interface? Well, we need an audio interface because it gives us all the basic connectivity we need. Without this, there really isn't a way to plug everything into your laptop. So it gives us your XLR microphone connector and also your quarter inch jack for guitars and instruments in general. The way it hooks up to your computer is via a single USB cable. Once you've installed your drivers, you just go to your audio preferences on your door, which stands for Digital Audio Workstation, which is just a fancy word for the software that you're using to record. In this case, we're using Logic, and you can see there I have the Steinberg UR242 selected, which automatically comes up once you've installed your drivers. So it's very easy to do. Now that that's selected, we can plug in our microphone or guitar and start recording. In this case, we have a condenser microphone. Because it's a condenser microphone, we need to run phantom power, which is your 48 volts, which is right there. Without that, it won't work, so we need that pushed in. So now that we've plugged our microphone in, we have phantom power on, and we've set up our input level. So we can see on the meter that we do have signal. There we go. So if I were to press record now, we can record the signal on that microphone. Now you can hear a click there. To avoid hearing it in the recording, you would have headphones on to monitor with, and they would just plug into the headphone jack just here on the front of the UR242. The second way to monitor what you're doing is to use studio monitors. The difference between studio monitors and your standard hi-fi speakers is that these have a relatively flat frequency response, which enables you to make decisions as far as EQing and compression. We're using active monitors, and they plug directly into the interface just using a standard guitar lead. So if we have a look at the back of the monitor, we can see it has a quarter inch or a guitar lead input, and it also has your standard microphone input. To record a guitar, there are a couple of ways you can do it. The traditional way is to stick a microphone in front of the amp. Most software these days come with modelling plugins, which just enables you to select your amp and speaker cabinet, and it also enables you to move your microphone around where you want it. So it's a virtual guitar amp, if you will. This makes it really, really simple, because all we need to do is grab our guitar and plug it directly in to an input of the audio interface, as you can see here. Go through various sounds depending on the style of music that you're recording. The benefit of doing it this way is that you can change the sound at any time. Unlike putting a microphone in front of a guitar amp, once you've recorded it, that's the tone that you have. This way, it enables you to go back and change the tone at any time. The other benefit is that you can run virtual pedal boards as well if you record in this manner using amp modelling. This allows you to grab various guitar effects like distortions, so you can pick up where you left off the next day and run a completely different amp or a different set of effects. Thanks for watching. It's Dominic from Cranbourne Music. Come and see us for anything you need for recording and music production. Stay tuned for more videos on recording tips and how-tos.